Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2034, 40 What Ifs with a Data Table. I am podcasting this entire book. Click the I in the top right-hand corner to get to the playlist. Today, we're going to talk about the second tool under What If Analysis. Yesterday, we talked about Goal Seek. Today, we're going to cover a data table. So, we have this nice little model here. This is a small model, 3 input cells, 1 formula. But this model could be hundreds of input cells, thousands of rows, as long as it comes down to one final answer. And we want to model this answer for several different values of two different input cells. For example, maybe we're interested in looking at different cars. So anywhere from 20,000 on up. So I'll put in 20 and 21,000 there, grab the fill handle and drag, take that down to 28,000. Across the top, we're looking at different terms. So 36 month loan, 42 month loan, 48 month loan, 54, 60, 66, and even 72. All right, now this next step is completely optional, but it really helps me to think about this. I always change the colors of the values along the top and the values along the left. And the really important thing here is that that corner cell, that all important corner cell, has to be the answer that we're trying to model. All right, so you have to start selecting from that corner cell with the answer, and then select all of the rows and all of the columns. We go into data, what if analysis, and a data table. And it's asking for two things here. And here's how you think about it. It says there's a whole bunch of different items along the top row of the table. I want to take those items one at a time and plug them into the model. Where should we input? So these items, these are terms, they should go into this cell B2. And then there's a whole bunch of items along the left-hand column. We want to take those one at a time and plug them into B1, like that. All right, and we click OK. Bam! It runs this model over and over and over. Now, just a little bit of cleanup here. I always go in and do home and probably zero decimal places like that, and maybe a little conditional formatting, color scales, and let's go with red numbers are large and green numbers are small, just to kind of give me a way to track this visually. And it looks like if we're shooting for $425, we're kind of at this spot or this spot, or maybe here, we'll all get us close to $425. So I can see what the various odds or various combinations are to get us to those values. Now, a couple things. This part inside of here is actually a big array formula, so equal table of B2 and B1, the row and column input. This is curious. You are not allowed to type this. You can only create this using data, what if analysis. You have to use that dialog box. If you try and type that formula, press Control Shift Enter, it will not work, right? So it's a function in Excel, but if you're smart enough to type it, too bad, it's not going to work. But it does constantly recalculate. So if we determine that we're only looking at terms from 48, and we want to look in groups of 3 or something like that. So as I change these numbers, all of that is calculating. In this case, it's only doing one formula for each, but imagine if it was doing 100 formulas, this could slow down dramatically. So out here under formulas, there's actually an option, calculation options, automatic or manual. There's a third one that says, yeah, recalculate everything except for the data tables. Don't keep recalculating the data table because this can be a huge drag on calculation times. All right, now, data tables are awesome when you have two variables to change, but we have 3 variables to change. What if there were different interest rates? Do I recommend going to the scenario manager? No, I never recommend going to the scenario manager. In this case, we have 9 rows by 7 columns. That's 63 different scenarios that we calculated here. To create 63 different scenario manager scenarios would take 2 hours. It's horrible. I don't cover this in the Mr. Excel Excel book because it's the 40 best tips. This is probably in my Power Excel book with 567 Excel mystery solved, but I'm sure that I complain about how miserable it is to use. You won't be seeing me do the scenario manager here. If we really had to do this for several different rates, the best thing to do is just control drag, take this sheet, control drag, control drag, control drag, and then change the rates on each sheet. So if we could get a 5% or 4.75% or something like that, and so on, right? There's no easy way to set that up for three variables in the scenario manager. All right, 40 greatest Excel tips of all time, all in this book. You can buy the book, click that I in the top right hand corner. Episode recap from today, there are three what if tools in Excel. Yesterday we talked about goal seek, today the data table. It is awesome for two variable problems. Tomorrow you'll see one with a one variable problem. The table array function cannot be manually entered, it will not work. You have to use data, what if analysis, data table. I used a color scale, home conditional formatting color scales to color the answers. If you have three variables to change, do you do scenarios? No, just make copies of the worksheet or copies of the table. They are slow to calculate, especially with a complex model. There is a calculation mode for automatic for all except tables. And O&W Green suggested including this feature in the book. So thanks to him and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.